guys, the Pro Ranger here. So today I'm going to be doing a camo job on my new AR-15. So as you can see, I've got things prepped already. I got my pistol grip taped off. I got my front and rear sights taped off. And my mags taped off where they're going to be up in the magwell. So we're going to be starting off with a khaki base coat. And then we're going to be doing the actual camo with the brown and green. And then we're going to finish it off with a matte clear coat. Anyway, let's get to it. So that's our first base coat with the khaki. I think it came out really nice. As you can see, you know, the trick to doing a nice paint job, a nice spray paint job, is not to just start barreling into it like this. No, you want to do nice even little spurts, very light, come at it from all different angles so you get into all the little parts. And this just goes for anything, whatever you're painting, you know. Anytime you're using spray paint, you're going to want to use the same techniques. Now, the reason you want to do that is because if you were to start going into it like this, it's going to create lots of drips. As you can see, that's building up. You don't want to do that. You know, when I was first learning how to spray paint, I screwed up many jobs doing that. Okay, so I'm going to let that dry for about, I don't know, 10 or 20 minutes. Just to make sure that when I flip it over, I'm not marking up the paint I just did, since I did such a nice job. You know, and also, it's probably best to do this outdoors. I'm kind of indoors right now, but I've got a big door open right here. You know, as you can see. So I've got plenty of airflow, but you don't want to do this in an enclosed space. You know, for those of you that have never worked with spray paint before, the fumes are very intoxicating and just bad for your health altogether. Oh, and one more thing, if you are new to working with spray paint, I really recommend using rubber gloves. You know, get ones that fit. What you don't want to have is too much loose ends right here, because what happens is it'll end up folding over, and as you're spray painting, it'll actually cause it to block the spray orifice, and it'll get a nasty pattern all over your whatever you're painting. It'll leave big spots. Alright, so while we're letting this dry, we're going to go ahead and get our sponges prepped. So you just buy these at any hardware store. These are like a dollar, maybe less. They're just little art sponges. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the tip off so that I have a square end. And then just to give it some texture, I'm just going to go ahead and start picking off little random pieces. There's probably an infinite number of ways you can camo a gun or anything for that matter. My advice to you, go online, go on YouTube or whatever and search how to camo a rifle or how to camo an AR or whatever. And then just find a pattern that you like and then do your best to try and match it. And like I said, it's not going to come out exactly the same, because every time you do something like this, you're creating randomness, and that's going to cause a customized job, which is cool. That's what you want. And you know, be creative. Don't necessarily go and buy these. You know, if you can find something else, maybe a kitchen sponge. You know, maybe there's some other thing that may make a cool pattern for you. You know, just be creative. Don't be afraid to try something different, try something new. You know, if all else fails, paint it again and start over. You know, just throw another light coat and you know, put another different kind of pattern on there if you want. Okay, so now I let it dry for about 20 minutes and I flipped it over, and I'm just going to repeat the same process on this side. Okay, so now that our base coat is dry, we're going to go ahead and put down the next darkest color, which is going to be our green. Instead of spraying this on, I'm going to use my sponge to apply it. And to do that, the best way to get the spray paint into the sponge, we're going to go ahead and just spray it into this little cup here. Okay, so I got some liquid in there. Just going to put it on our sponge like that. And before we do our gun, I took a piece of cardboard and put some of that khaki paint. And I'm just going to see. Yeah, see, I'm glad I did that because it was a little too wet. So you're just going to do a little test to see what it's going to look like. So that looks good. I'm happy with that. So now I'm just going to go ahead and just kind of randomly go around the gun and just kind of put big blots of paint. There's no real pattern here. I'm just kind of randomly placing it. I think that looks pretty cool to me. And we're gonna finish off our mags. The same thing, just absolutely random. And so if you feel like maybe you put too much dark in one spot, like I kind of felt like maybe there was a couple areas here where I put a little too much dark green, I just took one of these brushes that I had before and I sprayed on some of my khaki on there. And I just went around with the khaki and I just kind of dabbed it onto some of those spots just to break up the dark areas a little bit. Okay, so the last thing we're going to do is put our brown. We're going to use our sponge here. We're just going to get a little bit on that sponge, not too much. And just go around and just, like I said before, randomly put in that little pattern that you made. Okay, well, here's the finished product. I hope you guys like it. I'm really happy with the way it came out. You know, as I said, there's an infinite number of camo patterns you can use, so be creative. You know, if you're going to do this, it's a very cheap alternative to, say, having someone else do it for you. This cost me, I think, $25 total for all the paint. You know, obviously not including the gun, but, you know, assuming you have the gun already or you have whatever it is you're going to paint, go down, get yourself some whatever colors you want, get that clear coat, get some brushes or sponges or whatever you're going to use to apply it, and, you know, have some fun. So anyway, that's it. That is how you camo a gun. And like I said, this could be a gun, this could be a paintball gun, this could be a handgun, this could be your bicycle helmet, it could be your bicycle, it could be anything you want. You can camo your house if you want, if your neighbors don't mind. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.
Are you gonna shoot that?